Hey, New Life. Excited to get into God's Word with you today as we unpack another devotional. Growing up, I played a whole lot of different sports, football, basketball, baseball. But one of the hardest things in the world, I think, is making a free throw. It has nothing to do with how hard it actually is. It's about all the pressure that's put on you in that moment. I mean, you're 15 feet away from a basket and you alone have to take the ball and put it in the hoop. It's not only the fact that you're all alone and you're wide open, it's that there's a whole bunch of commotion going on. The crowd is usually yelling and urging you to miss that shot. There's players waving their hands. It's just really intense. There's a whole lot of pressure. And it's up to you to silence the noise, to silence the distraction, and to focus on making that shot. You know, the Christian life is similar to that. There's so many distractions and influences and voices to be heard, trying to get you and influence you to live a certain way. Yet our job as Christians should be to silence the noise, to quiet the distraction, and focus on Jesus. Unpacking a portion of scripture today found in Matthew chapter 14, verse 28 through 30. It's a story that you might have heard of before of Jesus walking on the water. Yet it might as well be Jesus and his friend Peter walking on the water, because Jesus is found walking to the disciples in the midst of a huge storm. And yet the disciples see him, they think he's a ghost. And Jesus says, "Take courage, for it is I." And Peter sees Jesus, and Peter, in typical fashion, is filled with boldness and kind of crazy response that he has. And it says this in Matthew chapter 14, verse 28. Peter calls to him, "Lord, if it's really you, tell me to come to you walking on the water." "Yes, come," said Jesus. So Peter jumped on the other side of the boat and walked on the water towards Jesus. Peter walked on the water towards Jesus. But then it said, when he saw the strong wind and the waves, he was terrified and he began to sink. You know, another translation says, as soon as he saw the wind and the waves. You know, when Peter took his focus off of Jesus and onto his weakness, onto his problems, onto his circumstance, he began to sink. And I think oftentimes in our lives as Christians, we lose focus on the person of Jesus and we begin to focus on our issues. You know, I think that focus is a very interesting thing because you can only focus on so many things at once. In fact, you could probably only really focus on one thing. And so some observations that I found from this is that there's distractions all around us. In my story of free throws, in this story of Peter walking on the water, there's people shouting. There's wind blowing, there's rain falling, there's hands being waved. And as a Christian, our job is to ignore all of those. And it's not so much ignore all of those, it's more focus on the things that matter. Focus on the person that matters. Focus on the Word of God that brings life to our lives. You know, you can focus on the news, you can focus on social media, you can focus on the pandemic, you can focus on politics, and that will leave you anxious, worried, depressed. I think we can all be honest in that one. But focusing on the person of Jesus, meditating on the Word of God, brings life, brings peace in our hearts. And so there's distractions, but choose to focus on the person of Jesus, because Jesus can be found in the midst of all circumstances. In this storm that's on the Sea of Galilee 2,000 years ago, Jesus was found in the storm. But he wasn't with the disciples. He wasn't with where they expected him to be, right next to him. No, Jesus was walking among the waters. Jesus is walking in the midst of what you're going through today. You are not alone. Jesus is walking towards you, and Jesus is calling you towards himself. But focus is what Jesus is asking from us. Some applications. Simply, what are you focused on today? What are the things that take up all of your attention? What do you give your money to? What do you give your time to? What do you give your thoughts to? What has your focus? Is it a person? Is it an influence? Is it a sports team as the NFL playoffs are winding down? No, what has your focus? If it's anything other than the person of Jesus, let me encourage you today to refocus. I love how easy it is for our eyes to focus and refocus on different things. You can hold your finger in front of your face and focus on your finger. And then without moving your head at all, you can focus on the thing that's behind your finger and then refocus on your finger. And you can refocus. Man, refocus on the person of Jesus. Sure, there's problems, but look past your problems and find Jesus. Sure, there's uncertainty. Look past your uncertainty and find Jesus. Yeah, there's rain falling and water going crazy. Look past those and find Jesus in the midst of your storm. Wherever you are today, refocus on Jesus. Let me pray. God, you're awesome and you're amazing. Lord, we worship you today. God, would you be the center of everything that we focus on? God, if we are focusing on our problems, God, I pray that you would be bigger than our problems. God, if we're focusing on the things that we don't have, Lord, I pray that we would focus on what we have in you. God, I pray that if we're focusing on that person, God, would we focus on you instead? God, I praise you today. Help us to be the people that you've called us to be. It's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Have a great rest of your day.